Hi there, I'm Natasha Antonioni with Austin Life, where we cover all things Austin, real estate, and design. Today, we're talking about color and how you use it in a space. It can be scary. And let me tell you something, I went down a long road of exploration to figure out how to make all of this digestible for you. So when I was working on the content for this video today, I kind of had imposter syndrome. If you've been here before, you've seen maybe tours of my two houses and they're pretty black and white. So it's like, who am I to talk about color? Well, there's a lot of intentionality behind that black and white. So let's dive in. There is just so much to say here. So we may have to break this video down into multiples, but today we're just gonna do an overview. So I was like, how do I get to the crux of what I'm trying to say here? Let me begin by saying that all rules are made to be broken. So when it comes to where we're starting at today, we're gonna go through the rules, but please know that intuition is always the most important thing. Let's get into some of the color theory. So there's a color wheel, and that color wheel has three primary colors. Don't worry, stay with me, it's gonna get more interesting. So the three primary colors are red, yellow, and blue. The reason why they're the primaries is because no two colors on the wheel can be mixed together to make those. Then we have the secondary colors. So the secondary colors are the colors that are the primaries mixed together. So for example, if you mix red and yellow, you get orange. If you mix blue and yellow, you get green. So you get the point. So the secondary colors are purple, green, and orange. Okay, moving right along and stick with me. Then we have the tertiary colors. That's when you take the secondary colors and then you mix those together. And with the tertiary colors, there's six colors there. Whew, we got through that. Next, we wanna talk about complementary colors. So complementary colors are colors that are opposites on the wheel. Why is that important? In a space, complementary colors create impact. They give it like a wow feeling. So what would be an example? Like orange and purple are opposites on the wheel. So picture a room where you have muted versions of those. They would create a lot of drama in a space. Black and white can create a lot of drama in a space. Green and red, think of Christmas. It creates a very strong pow kind of impact. So then we have the triadic, which is basically when you make a triangle any place on the color wheel, those three colors are your triadic colors. The other thing we want to think about is, are we going warm with our palette or are we going cool? So a cooler palette can give you more of an austere feeling. However, you can warm that up too, even staying within the cool palettes. And then obviously a warm palette is going to feel more sun-kissed, earthy, oranges, burnt oranges, that kind of thing. So even with the warm and the cool, like the idea is that you don't want to blend those two, but I have to say, I am loving seeing grays with gold accents right now. That's a big thing. And I think even that can kind of create that drama of the high contrast. So let's get into the actual colors and their significance. Now, I am a woo-woo girl. So what does that mean? My definition of woo-woo is actually like a higher sensitivity so that you can kind of feel the essence of the unseen world. Okay, without getting too out there, there's these things called chakras that everybody's heard about, right? So if you actually look at the chakras and you look at the significance of colors in a space, they line up. Is that an accident? I don't think so. So for example, your root chakra is at the base of your spine and it goes up through the rainbow just like that. So your root is red. Just beneath your belly button is orange. Your solar plexus is yellow. Your heart is green. Your throat is blue. Your third eye, which is your intuition, is purple. And then the top is white. So now if we look at the definitions of how these colors affect you, check it out because it matches up exactly. So how do we put this into the context of a home? My husband and I are strong characters. We are two alphas and we have no problem with expression. So in our younger years, we've been together for 20, there was a lot of passionate exchange verbally and in every other way. As we have grown and our houses have changed over the years, two houses ago, which you can see my Casa Cuernavaca tour, that house we painted a really soft hue of blue. You would never know it was blue unless I told you. It was that subtle. And we fell in love with the lightness and the freshness and the airiness of how it affected the home. So people say that cool tones can feel cold. Well, I don't always agree with that because that home to me feels calming, soothing. And when I think back to that color choice and how our communication and expression has evolved over the years, and I only thought of that from doing this video, I'm like, wow, it really did have an impact on our relationship and our family. As we've evolved, we are still these kind of strong characters. So we're currently in a black and white moment. The way that we make that work so it doesn't feel too in your face, and you can check out my Casa Westward tour, is that we blend in the neutral tones and lots of green to keep the space feeling homey and lived in and like a home and not this like boom museum. When we moved to Austin, we did a full gut remodel on this house that we purchased. We went for that high contrast with the neutral. So we had lots of pops of black and we had that light blue on the walls, which really looks like white, and then kind of neutral tones complementing the high contrast. As you can see in this picture, the high contrast with the neutral still creates a warm and inviting environment. But let's take a look at what the house looked like before the remodel. Now, it wasn't bad at all. We bought the house because we loved what they had done. We knew that we could put our own flavor on it. So they had a lot of color going on in that house, even though it was muted. For our taste, there was just a little bit too much going on. We wanted a cleaner, fresher palette. So you can see how they had all that color going on in the kitchen and we just cleaned the palette up because we wanted it was really a fresh new start for us. It's funny, when you look back, you can kind of see the symbolism of what was going on at different points in your life related to the colors that you chose. So this moment that we're in, that's the black and white moment of our lives, can be complemented with earthy and lots of green. You can really create these kind of majestic environments that still feel warm and inviting. So let's talk about tone on tone palettes. It makes you feel kind of soothed, relaxed, calm. Many spas have tone on tone or even high-end hotels. Look at this beautiful bathroom by Wood Melbourne. I just love the soft tonality of the space. You just feel like you want to wash your face in that sink. And the Broadware bathroom, they went kind of more the terracotta path. So it was like these soft terracotta tones meets creams and whites. I love this example by Studio Atara, where they went kind of white on white with just little pops of gold accents. But tone on tone doesn't only have to be soft colors. You can actually go full color and go tone on tone. Look at this impactful kitchen with all these different shades of blue. You feel like, wow, I've not been in a space like this before. And then there's this living room by Domus Nova where it's all blue on blue. It has this real Japanese kind of tone to it and it makes you feel kind of soothed and relaxed. But it's all about the tonality that you choose. Because in this last image, it's really moody. The colors have a little bit of gray thrown into that blue, so it makes it feel kind of moody, more sensual. When you get into the tertiary color palette, it has more vibrancy because you're dealing with three colors, right? So if you want to add that kind of pop to your space, you may want to think about using three colors. I love this example where they went with orange, purple, and bluish green. It really feels like festive, like you want to make a margarita in that space. Here's another example where the background is white, but you still have the pops of color, and that in itself can be like a contrast. And then when you go for the muted palette, you can take the tertiary colors but mute them down so it is almost like a tone on tone, but you're using a mix of different colors. So I know it can be overwhelming, but I wanted to share a couple of stories from clients that I've been working with. So there is this couple, like, you don't want to overthink this whole color thing. So I'm working with this lovely couple, and she came to me with examples of the palette that they had in mind. And there were all these really kind of neutral tones with really soft, muted, like, think of a burnt orange or a terracotta just scaled way down, or sage green but scaled way down. And I loved her palette, and I didn't want to go through this whole story of like, what kind of color are you looking for? I didn't want to do that deep dive. She had already done it. She had trusted her intuition. And I know this couple, and both of their personalities are very, very soft and soothing. So it just made perfect sense. So that's an example of following your own intuition. So if you're attracted to something, don't think about it too much. It's nice to have the rules if you're starting with a concept in mind and you want to bring something forward, but you're not sure what that is. But if you have that feeling and you kind of know what you're leaning towards, go with that. If you are starting with that kind of empty canvas and you're like, what do I want to build in my next life? What do I want to create? On this channel, my whole thing is intentional design. So when we're doing our houses, we think like designers, and we think, what do we want to build into this space? What do we want to create? What is the essence of the feelings that we want to have in here? So if you think about that, you can look at those colors, find the significance, and then choose how to invite them into the space. So again, right now we're in a room with a soft blue wall. You'd never know it. You'd think it was white, right? But it does create this real sense of calm. And remember, our communication has gotten much more relaxed.
Okay? You get two spaces, I get one.
Let me guess, yours is bigger. So recently I was in Miami and we went to have dinner at the Four Seasons. Man, is it stunning. Super beautiful. They always are, right? Well, what they did was they really honored the space. It had been an old clubhouse on the beach, and they took this existing space and they just enhanced it. And the way that they did that was that they went neutrals with almost everything. Lots of green, as you can see by these beautiful white arches that are so high. You can see how the palm leaves kind of enhance the existing arches that were there, but everything else is kind of tone on tone, very natural. When I was in that space, it kind of envelopes you. So in this channel, when we're talking about design, we often talk about a focal point. Sometimes you don't want to have a focal point. Sometimes the entire space can be the focal point. And you can do that by using neutral tones, having beautiful features throughout the space, and the use of nature indoors, so lots of plants. And this last image, it's one of the rooms at the Four Seasons. What I love about it is that the room almost disappears because it's so understated that it makes the windows and the view everything. So that is sometimes the key, because your focal point could be the outdoors. I'm working with some clients and dear, dear friends of mine in California on a project. They just bought a gorgeous home. They're engulfed in the redwoods, but you have an ocean view. Where do you find that in the world? So we want to make the space all about the view. So when we were deciding on the furnishings that belong in this space, we agreed that the furnishings should be really neutral, really soft, beautiful pieces that can stand on their own. But when you walk in that space, you just think it feels good and your gaze is at that view, because the view is the focal point. So when you're thinking about yourself and your space, you wanna kind of consider these things. You wanna consider, but you also wanna trust your intuition, because nobody knows how your space should be better than you. And if you're working with a designer, the designer's job is to pull that out of you, because maybe that's not what you do, and maybe you don't really know how to think about these things, but that's okay. A designer's job is to help you to figure that out. So we do have a video coming up in the future, very soon, where I'm gonna take you through my design process and how I do it for myself in my own life and how I do it for my clients. Because if a client's coming to me, it's my job to figure out who they are and how do I imbue that space with them. It shouldn't be about me, it should be about the client. Yeah, I know it's a lot to digest. Like I said at the beginning of this video, it was like I went down a rabbit hole and just tried to make it as simple and tight as possible for today's video. But listen, tell us in the comments below, what are your challenges? What are you afraid to express? Are you afraid to use color? Color can be scary, but if it comes back to being intentional, you can ask yourself, what do I want to create in this space? And from that point, you can then choose your palette.